taking those deep breaths. Breathe in and out. Got to talk to my own body today. Greetings and love and kindness, family. I'm Karen Khadija Davis-Foulks, the one and only Conscious Self Healthcare Educator and host of the Conscious Self Healthcare Conversation Radio Show. Every Wednesday from 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Community, this is your time to share your wellness stories and how you move from disease care to conscious self healthcare. I want to hear your story. We want to hear from you. Join the conversation each Wednesday. Call in and share how you shift out of chronic disease care stress right here on innerlightradio.com, the healing frequency. This is Dr. K, and I am looking forward to our conversation. So call in and share. Health is consciousness, and healing is a function of consciousness. Come on, family. It's time to rock the world with the new frontier of conscious self-healthcare. While I share my wellness story with you right here on innerlightradio.com, the healing frequency. Moving to that beat. Even when that body can't move like you wanted to move, do it in your mind. Feel it in your heart. Let your cells talk to you. I'm talking to myself today, family. I talk to myself every day as I share with you. But the message is for me today. Are you free now? Are you free to think the way you want to think? To move the way you want to move? Share love the way you want to share love? How free are you, family? Expressing that beat. Do you like what you see? Dancing. Dancing moves the body. All kinds of directions. If you're feeling good, you gotta dance. For dancing with me today, sending me that vibration today. Seven 24, 2019. 7/24/2019. It's still in my vibration of my Earth Day. What was going on in July 1957? A whole lot of stuff was going on. Just like we know, they burned tons and tons and tons of quantum information that you can't destroy anything, even when you try to turn it into fire and send it up in flames. How you doing, family? Take that deep, 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 deep breath today. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for sharing this broadcast with a friend, with your neighbor, with a colleague, with somebody you know that this broadcast could benefit. Thank you so very much for tuning in, for visiting the YouTube channel, for going back and listening to the rebroadcast shows. I do it all the time because it inspires me to stay in the zone of love. Y'all know love. Love, L-O-V-E. Just feeling the vibration of the words and being here on Inner Light Radio. The healing frequency, it always shifts my energy and my body is in that balloon state today. And I'm going to share with you why in a moment. But I'm feeling good and I'm thankful and I'm blessed because I'm here. Because I still want to be here on planet Earth, sharing a message, spreading a word, bringing in harmony and peace and happiness and understanding energy. The more of us is connects and collects that energy vibration and send it out, it makes other people's energy shift. Because love is the power that brings my and your entire life together. It heals, renews, restores, and empowers me with divine energy and life. The breath. That breath that lets you know that everything's fine. You want that breath to be smooth and not choking and not stopping, you know. You want it to be a natural flow. You want to feel it through your whole body. That signifies life. So I'm love in action. You are love in action. I'm a master of positive self-expression, and so are you. And we're expressing ourselves today. You're sitting back. You're tuned into yourself. You're listening to the message. And you are connecting with yourself where you need to fill in the correct vibrations from the message. Because we are here to be givers and receivers of love. And that's what this radio show is all about. I'm here to be a giver of love. And I receive that love back from your vibrations. They are strong. They penetrates any blockages and any lack of quality oxygen that's going on in the atmosphere. Any cloaks that have been put up to hide, all veils are being dropped down. All cloaks are being dropped down. The energy is strong. It comes from each of us on planet Earth. Whether we are aware of it or not, we are connected one to one another and our ancestral realm, how they touch us through individuals that connects. And we have to be aware of that and thankful for the vibration of love. Nothing binds us except our thoughts. Nothing limits you except your fears. Nothing controls you except your beliefs. Nothing heals you except your consciousness. And that's why I have to put myself and my consciousness in a state of purification to know that what I'm doing and what I'm feeling now and what I've been feeling all week is a part of the shift of the energy of what I have been doing for the physical body, working with these cells, shifting the energy of these cells to continue to move forward and move my body out of this state, but it seemed like it's picking up wind. But that's all right, too, because I trust and I know that everything that I am doing is bringing about a positive change in my body, even though it feels like it is not. And I want to stop and say, no, I can't stop and say no, because I know what I'm doing is correct, is right. Because one thing for sure and two things for certain, I ain't doing no pharmaceuticals, and that's what blocks everything. So long as you're doing the right thing as far as your diet goes, and that diet can blend. Because according to what you're going through, you might have to do some different things that you never thought you was going to do based on who you think you are according to your diet. And there's all kinds of diets out there that people follow. And some people get so adamant about their diet, I'm not going to do this. But they can't see that they may lack something that got them in that state that they're in from their diet. they may have to change their diet and shift some things. So I'm here to say that we got to think about those things that we fear. False education accepted as reality. False evidence appearing real. Oh, we got to face that fear. We got to rise with it. We got to rise in consciousness. So I thank you for joining me today. Thank you for tuning in to the Conscious Self-Healthcare Conversation Radio Show. I'm your host, Cameron Khadijah Davis, folks, the one and only Conscious Self-Healthcare Educator, showing you today that you can become the one and only Conscious Self-Educator for yourself when you sit back and make those choices that benefit you and your life. So thank you for coming to breathe with me and dance with me and relax my energy. And taking those deep, 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 deep breaths when the body gets into a heavy vibrational state. Love is all there is. That's what I keep telling myself. It's all about love. So I ask you, as I ask myself every day, are you ready to leave that man-made mindset of human consciousness about health care? Yeah, because sometimes I tell you, your body can go through some things and you feel like you want to shift and you want to go to them. But you got to know what they're going to do. And then you shift your energy back and say, I can't go to them. I got to go back to myself. I got to ask myself, what am I doing? What am I not doing? What do I need to do? Do I need to rest? Do I need to change my diet? Do I need to add more water in? Do I need to add more exercises in? Certain kinds of exercises. What do I need to do for myself? Are you asking yourself that question? What have I been doing? Has that been really, really working for me? Do I need to do something different? Or it have worked up to a point, and now I must make a different choice to do something different to extend myself so I can continue on with my journey of correcting my cellular malfunctions and not diseases. Y'all know we can do that. So are you ready, family? Are you ready to sit back today and relearn, rethink, and rewrite your personal health care prescription plan for better health? Are you ready to do that? Because I sit here and I share with you, so much be coming to me. You can do this, Karen. Oh, you can do that, Karen. Just by being on the radio sharing, hearing all the other vibrations and having my mind talking about something, which opens up a doorway for that ancestral realm of energy to come in and come down and say some things to you. And I'm telling you, they've been talking this month, talking, telling me so much. And they doing it all day. They've been doing it all day today. And I'm like, can I do the show today? My mind is all over the place because so much information is coming down to me saying, do you remember when this happened in 2013? Do you remember this happened in 2014? You know, you haven't heard from that person since 2015. And wow, let me tell you what that person was really doing. And let me tell you what that person was really saying. And but it's all coming together now. You know, you handled everything so beautifully. So a lot of things are happening. And like I say, energy has a lot to say to you around your Earth Day because they figure that you're open and you're excited and you're thinking about people that had left, you know, and you wanted to share that information about them. So we got to understand and we got to recognize and we got to remember that, yes, family, yes, community, our cells are always and always talking to us. And boy, are they talking to me today. They've been talking so much today. I was like, okay, are you going to settle down a little bit? I'm a little bit settled down, but not much. I'm in this balloon state, I'm telling you. But it's a little bit different this time. Something going on. And all I know is that I'm doing everything correctly. So what's going on may be a major push because I did kind of shift my diet a little bit because we know for a fact that it can be vice versa. But the correct thing is fruits are cleansers and vegetables are builders. Some vegetables are cleansers. Some fruits are builders. But for the most part, fruits are for the cleansing of the body. So no, I'm not being a fruitarian again, but I have shifted my diet to do fruits and certain kinds of fruits at different times to allow my body to get into a more purified state of cleansing itself. And at the same time, I'm building, but I'm building with herbs from common sense. So I'm doing the herbs, I'm doing the water, I'm doing fruits. And I'm telling you, my body is shifting and so much is going on, definitely when it deals with the nervous system. I'm telling you, that one system right there, that's why every pharmaceutical shuts it down. It shuts down on the lymphatic system because it don't want it to do its job. But my nervous system is doing its job. My lymphatic system is doing its job. And all I can do is be thankful and just say I'm just blessed and thankful that it is working. The systems are back doing their jobs. I can feel it cleaning up. I can feel things shifting. Oh, my body get into the state, and I'd be like, oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. I have to end that old with that. I have to say thank you. So our cells are always and always talking to us. We just need to learn or know how to listen to them. That's how you make conscious self-healthcare moves. Mental observation view is essential for self-success. So I put myself in a state and I sit back and I listen to see what my cells are trying to say to me. Get into a more purified state. Remember I told you last week and the week before that, just keep telling me that you might think you're going to remove a lot of waste from your body, a lot of shit from your body, but I'm telling you, people just don't know. Even when they change their diet after 2 and 3 years, they think they change their diet, but the body still holds on to so much waste. And you think because you're pooping regularly that you've gotten all the waste out of your body. Well, I'm going 3 times a day, or I'm going 2 times a day, and I don't eat that much, so the one time is great. Our bodies can hold that matter from so many years ago within the walls of the cells, around the cells, in the colon. And I'm telling, being a colon hydrotherapy therapist, always giving myself colonics at least 2-3 a week when I had my system for what, 12 years almost. I'm telling you, matter can stay in the body. So I'm helping it. So the message is clear. I'm following it. I clear the pathway. I just free my mind. I'm just saying, okay, let me get this human consciousness. Let me push it to the side. Get out of the way. Stop trying to control stuff sometimes. Listen to what your cells and your body is trying to say to you. Listen to what the energy is trying to reveal to you. Get out of the way. Stop trying to be in control so much. And sit back and listen sometimes to your own body, to your own self. I ain't say to anybody else. I'm talking about to yourself. It says you are standing at the safe way, that safe gateway. A positive organic expression. And so that's what I'm doing. So I'm all over the place. I have to ask myself sometimes, am I making sense? Because like I say, sometimes energy come down right now and just snatch me to the side. And I'd be like, what did I just say? I got to bring myself back to that thought. But sometimes I can't bring myself back to that thought because they snatched me up, gave me some information, dropped me back down. And I'm like, where am I at? I'm back down here now. I need to know where I'm at, what I'm doing, what I'm saying. What we know is always about making conscious self-healthcare moves. That's what this show is all about. It gets you to sit back and take that deep, 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 deep breath. Put in your mind that you're activating that kundalini snake in the body as it goes up the spine and it reveals in each section. And it works with all your energy centers and all your energy plants. And it's aligning everything. It's sending out those waves. And it's connecting to every organ that works within that structure of that area of the spine. And if you have that in mind and conscious, every time you take a deep breath and you're telling your body to send it out, to send out those good energy waves and break up anything that's trapped, to allow to move freely through the body and not get stagnated anyplace else. You know, I'm freeing out the energy of that excess fluid and excess sodium in the brain, trapped around the face, trapped around my eyes. I'm sending the message to move down, and things are happening more and more and more. The eyes are running more and more. People saying, what's going on? Your eyes are running. This eye's red. That eye's just, yeah, the eyes are clearing up because I want to see the life that I'm creating now. I had demise in the state of, why is everybody doing this? I don't feel like looking at none of this. So I'm going to shift that energy. I want to see. I want to see clearly. You showed it to me clearly anyway. So I might as well say open up the eyes and see it even more clear now. So I put my state, my body in that state to receive the goodness of life so that I can move forward, because we already know what one of the masters had to say to us. He said, you are the master of your thoughts and mind. He said, tell your mind what to think. He said, tell your feelings what to feel and tell your body how to react. And Lord knows I'm doing all that today 100%. Master your mind, master your feelings, master your thoughts. All righty now. I'm telling this holographic image what to do, how to act, and how to think. And some people say, girl, you insane. That's insanity. Nah, that's sanity. When you realize that you can sit back and as your sales talk to you, you can listen and respond. Because you know that through the motion. You know that through what you're doing and how you're feeling. The body gives you that information. And you have to be willing to listen, respond, and obey. Obey? Yeah. Obey the message. Obey the truth. So, as I talk to you, I'm sitting back. I'm taking a deep, 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 deep breath. I'm feeling this breath move up my body to the top of my toes, from the top of my toes to the top of my head. Lord, and it sets up there and it moves. I can feel certain things happen up in the brain areas, like get out the way, get out the way, get out the way, push down, move down, clear the pathway. You got to clear this pathway. You got to move on down. You got to clean those systems out in the brain. You got to let things occur. That front lobe, that back lobe, the middle two lobes. All four quadrants up there. So release and listen here as we take this universal love ride on the friendship train. We on a Harriet Tubman's ride from Pharmacide, Nutricide, and yes, oh yes. Whatever diet is not supporting your body the way it needs to support your body, it's a sad, 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 sad diet. And so you want to leave that diet because you are creating your life from conscious creation, not from a man-made mindset of human consciousness. We're not doing that. So once again, family, the question that I'm asking you to hold in mind, to hold in thought through the week, and I know y'all been thinking about it, what are the emotions, beliefs, and values involved with stopping you from being healthy, happy, and loving? And as I said in last week's show, you can schedule yourself for that next scan. I'm going to show you what your emotions truly are. I'm going to show you your belief patterns. I'm going to show you the value system you have. I'm going to show you a lot of things. And if you're not familiar with what NES can see, go on out to my website, ConsciousSelfCare.com, ConsciousCiouselfCare.com. Click on a link that talks about NES provision or go to NESHealth.com. Go out to the site. See what they have to say about the instrument that they allow people to use to read their human body field. And see if it's something that you want to do for yourself to get a better picture of how you're thinking energetically, what's going on with your cells, how it's matching to the cosmos, down to the level of chemical processing. We can see it all. You can see it all. And it's amazing when you see it all. And I'm telling you, Peter Frazier and the work that he did to bring about mapping of the human body, I'm telling you, it's nothing like it. The stuff is real. It's on point. If you ever thought that you didn't have frequency and vibration, the cells does not giving off with anything, I'm telling you, if you haven't had a NES scan, you need to have a NES scan. And if you're true to yourself, you're going to be shocked. You're going to be amazed. So I want you to sit back. Think about those things and what you have been thinking about, and are you coming to an answer for yourself? Because we do have free will in every area of our life, and definitely with the care of this human body. We have free will. We have so much free will. As long as we don't give our power to people, places, or things. When you share too much information, too many people coming in giving you so much advice, you really can't make your own decision. You got to sit back and you have to relax and you have to give yourself an opportunity to process. And if you've been stuck in a pattern for a long, long time, you may have thought for a while that you were doing everything correctly. Then the body slowed down. You got a cellular malfunction. You had to go to the hospital. And now you think you got to do pharmaceuticals. That's never the answer. It's something you're missing nutritionally, something you're missing in your consciousness, something you're missing in your actions. It's something that you are not doing for yourself. It never comes through a pharmaceutical. If anything, that's a temporary measure. Once you awake and understand what's going on, you have to shift that energy and look at yourself and look at all areas of your life and see where your malfunctions may be. It could be a cellular malfunction. It could be a thought malfunction. But you have to look and see for yourself. We don't have to conform to anyone's belief system that we feel no longer serves us. I don't care who it is, your doctor, your minister, I don't care who it is, a lawyer, your girlfriend, your longtime friend. I don't care who it is. If it's not really matching what you want to do, then you got to not do that. You got to not think the way they want you to think, because that's the beginning of all the shifts in the body. You being out of balance with your own self. The reality of it is we are often so blind to our own patterns that we do not see what it is, a habit of thought, of action, or response. So again, as you ask yourself those other questions, am I doing something that's a habit of thought, is a habit of action, or I'm quick to respond all the time the same way? What am I doing? We have to look at ourselves to reinvent ourselves and know what's going on with ourselves. So take a little time to listen to the words you say, the thoughts you think, and the pictures you create. Because that's definitely what I've been telling myself this week. Because I'm creating this major change and a lot is going on. And so I have to say to myself, Karen, you know, you're changing your whole diet. You're changing how your sleeping patterns. You're changing a lot of things. You're not doing this way anymore. And so it's going to bring about a reality. You may think you may know what it's going to be, but we're showing you what it's looking like. And so you have to accept that, and you have to be able to relax. So, yeah, I'm thankful that I'm retired. Yeah, retired a long time ago from working for corporate America. But I'm retired, just had to sit back, and I'm able to relax. And I'm thankful for that, because a lot of people are not able to do that. But there's other ways you can do that by having those intermittent breaks in your life throughout your day. You can still give it to yourself, not getting caught up in things that you really cannot change, the way your job is, the way your family, friends are, situations are, not giving it a whole lot of power. We have to really, really think about that. So are you ready to question your beliefs, your knowledge, and your behavior? I sure do. I sure do. I'm telling you, I really, really do, and I do it for myself. Yeah, I'm a counselor and all of that, but I do it for myself. I talk to myself. I write things down. I go back. I review it. I look at it, and I ask myself, you know, are you stuck somewhere? You know, are you not acknowledging something? What you do that? What was that behavior about? You know? You have to do these things for yourself. You can become your own wellness coach. You can become your own counselor. You can become your own psychologist. And no, it's not crazy when they say you're trying to be your own doctor. Yeah, you can be your own doctor. You can be your own lawyer. You can be it all. But you got to be objective about yourself and what you're doing. So I want you to sit back, and we're going to get ready for a station break. And when I hear that music coming in, I know that we can sit back and take a deep, deep, deep breath and think about what we're doing and how we're doing it. So family, happiness is not something that you postpone for the future. It's something you design for the present. Can't nothing bring it down unless you allow it in your consciousness. So sit back and take a deep breath.
Do you feel lost? Do you feel out of sync? Could it be that you are experiencing electromagnetic sensitivity? Yes, electromagnetic sensitivity. Could man-made frequencies interfere with cellular activity and melatonin production? We are beings of frequency, light, and information, and you are your own experience. Do not conform any longer to the patterns of man-made mindset of human consciousness. Be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Schedule your NEST ProVision Human Body Field Scan with Dr. K, 202-248-7749. Visit the website forcellife.com. The number 4CELLLIFE.com. Have the courage to expand your horizon and reprogram your cellular activities. Call Dr. K for your 15-minute wellness consultation. 202-248-7749. All of my sisters and my brother.
Forget that together we stand, and divided we fall, all for one and one for all. Oh, let
Is going to give us a quick message, family. Sit back and keep breathing. Taking those deep, deep breaths and thinking about who you help and how you help yourself with health education for longevity and peace. That's what we got to do. We got to sit back.
So your response to some extent is a rejection of evangelical Christianity, which has attempted to focus black people's mindset on reaching heaven beyond death, as opposed to focusing on the here and now. So the question still is there any room for that conversation, that how to get to heaven when you die, that you said you haven't heard much from T.D. Jakes? Is that an important message? Is that something?
Not for me, because to me, you see, now, okay, my interpretation is that life is a matter of consciousness and states of consciousness.
Okay.
And to me, heaven and hell are both states of consciousness.
Okay.
And I remember when I illustrated it several times to my various audiences, and I said, nobody is going to dispute me when I tell you that you don't have to die to go to hell. Because most of you have caught some kind of hell in some kind of way. Hmm. And everybody would, amen, amen. You know, everybody would, yes, yes, yes. So I said, by the same token, you don't have to die to go to heaven. It's a matter of state of consciousness.
So should people be worried about what happens when they die?
I say no.
Okay.
Only one thing you take with you when you die, and that is your consciousness, your self-consciousness. And your self-consciousness will take you to whatever is of its nature, to whatever is correlative with it. And you see, this is what I teach in mind science, my brand of it. And that's all that goes with you. I sent my soul to the other realm. Some lesson of the future state to spell. And by my soul returned and said, I myself am heaven and hell.
And just know that health is all about consciousness. That's why I keep telling them I put myself in a state of consciousness to pay attention to what I have been doing and what's going on. So you can take health out and put anything you want in front of that. But health is a state of consciousness. And healing is a function of consciousness. Understanding that state of consciousness, and I'm healing from that. But what is that state? There are different states of consciousness. And what state do you put your conscious in? And you have to put yourself in that state of consciousness where you know that you are in control of it all. You understand the connective, but the separation, which is in the real reality of the consciousness and the human body. It's all one. It's connected. Down is up, and up is down, and in is out, and out is in, and it's all connected as one. And that's how we have to see it. So that's why you hear me always saying, I have to put myself in the right state of consciousness while I'm going through what I'm going through. And y'all know, well, I love River Nike. Like I told y'all last week, Mama, I ain't going to church no more. I'm going over there with Aunt Bert and listen to Reverend Knight. And she kept saying, you got to stay in church until you're 12. And I wanted to say, why? But sometimes you got to answer that why for yourself. You can't turn around and ask mama why. Because she'll come around and say, because I said so. Then I would have to say, well, mom, you always told us about that word because I said so. Can you break it down? And she'd be like, damn, why did I teach y'all to do that? Rebellion is when you look to society and you say it in their face. And you say, I understand who you want me to be. However, I'm going to show you who I actually am. Who are you? Who are you? What is your I am? What is there? I am that I am. What is that in the middle? What state of consciousness do you have yourself in, family? What state of consciousness do you have yourself in? Reverend Ike, affirmations. God in me has given me the power to create my experiences by means of my imagination. What are you imagining? You're thinking one thing, you're wishing another, you're hoping for something, but what's really in the imagination? That's what you're creating. You have to look and see, what's in my life? Do I like what I see over there? Then how did that get there? Then what is really in my imagination? I got to shift some things. I got to find out what's really going on. Yeah, you got to look at yourself. You got to look at your life. You got to see what's going on because, believe me, that's what everybody else is doing, sitting back, passing judgment, which they really shouldn't be doing, but they sitting back. But you look at your life and see if you're creating the life that you have in mind, that you have in that imagination. Is there a match? Is it producing what you want? I am using my imagination to see all good I desire in my experiences through my expression. I'm using my imagination to see that. I'm visualizing that. And then I can see glimpse of sand, shift a minute, change some things. It's okay. Let's eat some more fruits. Let's drink some more water. Let's get going to the bathroom a little bit more. Let's just sit back. You got enough protein from the meat in your body for a minute. Let's just sit back and let's do some cleansing and see what happens. So how do we cleanse? We cleanse with fruit. We cleanse with water. Or we cleanse with nothing. We sit back. We don't eat every hour of the day. You got to listen. You got to say, I'm full. I don't need any more. My body is correcting itself. I gave it all the nourishment that it needs for today. I just want that. Don't just want something that's not going to serve you and give you what you need. You got to make conscious self-health care moves. Mental observation view essential for your success. Have you been doing that this week? You know, if you want to come on to the Conscious Self-Health Care Conversation radio show, all you got to do is email me, Facebook me, send me a message, say, Karen, I got a story I want to tell. Khadija, I got a story I want to tell. Let me tell you what I did for myself. Let me tell you how I moved through this cellular malfunction storm that they call such and such and such and such and such and such. And they had me taking this and that and that and that. And then I felt myself going deeper down that rabbit hole. And I was like, wait a minute, what can I stop first? Well, let me stop the pharmaceuticals because they told me, they wrote it down. They're telling me what it's going to do to me, that it's going to cause more problems, that it's going to affect another system, that I'm shutting down my lymphatic system, that I'm shutting down my immune system. The body can't do its job to correct itself because I'm shutting down the major systems. And I got to stop doing that first. That's what Karen had to do. And that's what she did. And that's what you can do, too. And then you can join me here on innerliferadio.com, The Healing Frequency, right here again on the Conscious Self Healthcare Conversation Radio Show, sharing your story. So you can put it in that group on Facebook, Wellness Stories. Put it in that group right there. Go to the Lymphatic Wellness Group. Put something over there. Connect with me any way you can. Karen, Khadija, Davis-Foulks, F-O-U-L-K-S. I want to open up the lines. I want to hear these stories. I want to hear how people are shifting their energy, how they're working towards making their human body better. What are they doing different? You're getting older now. You're in your 50s. I've been past those. I'm in my early 60s. And I got to make some major, 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 major shifts in my life. And I'm doing that because I got to go past 80. I think my grandmother was here 88. Got to go past 88. I got to live longer to shift. Even though through my mother's side of the family, I'm her last living child. My father's side of the family, I have three siblings on that side, so that's good. His lineage goes on. I got to keep my mother's lineage around here for a long time, and prayerfully my siblings' children will be blessed and live a long, healthy life if they just do half the things that Aunt Karen is sharing with them to do and shifting their energy. And don't wait too late, because how you feed your body in your 20s is going to represent you in your 30s. The same way in your 30s is your 40s, and your 40s is your 50s, and your 50s is your 60s. And some people ain't making it past the 50 mark. And you don't want to be like that, the younger generation, where they're saying that you won't outlive other people. Everybody got to make that positive shift to do things better for themselves. So in looking in terms of the revealing word, what it gives you about the word health, a state of being sound or hold in mind and body, oneness with the Christ mind assures perfect health. Health is the normal condition of man, a condition true to the truth of his being. Health is the normal condition of man, a condition true to the truth of his being. Health is from within and doesn't have to be manufactured in the without. Health is from within and doesn't have to be manufactured in the without. What does that really mean to you? What is that saying to you? It is the very essence of being, universal and enduring. That's what health is. That which seems to be sickness does not exist in truth. Because why? It shifts. It shifts all the time. When man becomes so much at one with the God mind that he abides in the consciousness of health. I know I'm healthy. I know everything fine. I know the body is making shifts. I know it's not about a disease, and in harmonious condition in mind and body, brought about by error thinking, because I don't think diseases. I think cellular malfunctions, because cells can malfunction. So disease, and in harmonious condition in mind and body, brought about by error thinking. Ignorance causes all diseases. Ignorance causes all diseases. He says, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. Organic disease has its origin in mind as truly as any other manifestation. Mind. It has become subconscious and needs the power of the Christ mind, the higher mind, to reach and to dissolve the error thoughts that are causing the disease. Yeah, there was some error thoughts going on, and I corrected the error thoughts, but the body manifested something. It showed up as a stroke. Thank God I didn't go all the way down that rabbit hole, and I made some corrections. And the body is still correcting itself. I have to honor the body. I have to hear what it said, and I have to listen to it. And one way I do that is understanding the power of the lymphatic system. And that's what I suggest that you all do. Take the moment to learn about the lymphatic system of the human body. They want to separate it and say there's a separate lymphatic system of the brain. They want to talk about that, but it's all one system. And you have more lymphatic vessels than you have blood vessels in your body. And you want to get them to work at its optimum. So you want to learn about that lymphatic system. It's like the tree in your body. The branches go up inside the head. The roots go down in the feet. And the trunk is right there in the chest. This is called the thoracic duct. Its main function is to keep your cells in the living state, the dry state. And that's when I'll be talking about not too much excess fluid, not too much excess sodium, which causes the fluctuation in energy. Energy becomes chaos, not flowing correctly, and things begin to shift. So you got to have plenty of oxygen. That's why we have to have oxygenated food. We want the purest water that we can find. And we want to take those deep, deep breaths and activate that body's system of thought with oxygen. Because oxygen equals pumps. The pumps got to work. That's your cells. Cells are working all the time to generate what? Electricity. To do what? To give you power. So every cell has at a basic level that sodium potassium pump. Conditions for a healthy cell: high potassium within the cell, low sodium within the cell. And so your body can keep a balance of in and out, that flow, keeping everything balanced, the water inside and outside. So you want to learn the lymphatic system. And I know 100% that is what this anger in me that allowed me to move through any healthcare storm that comes on. No matter what I think, no matter what I hear, I go back and bring up the information on the signs of lymphology, cellular ecology, knowing those prime variables, knowing what they mean, asking myself the right questions so I can stay on track. Because I told you, doctors are neuro-linguistic programmers. They will program you into believing anything and everything. And don't let yourself go through one or two things and you come back to that doctor and they be like, without saying it, see what I told you? You need this drug. If you don't take this drug, you're not going to get what you need. That's never the answer. It's never the truth. You got to remember that's how they get paid, to diagnose you and prescribe surgeries or drugs. And it's always unnecessary to remove an organ because an organ can get rid of its flood. But it takes you to do that for that organ to get rid of its flood. So family, remember, water in the bloodstream follows the blood protein. Trapped proteins will pull water out of the bloodstream and make you thirsty. The thin guy who has a tight cellular structure can have just as much trapped protein in his body and can be just as sick as a big guy with a loose cellular structure. So anybody think because they're tiny that you can't have excess fluid and excess sodium, stop eluding yourself, because you just like some balloons you can blow up. And some balloons take you a long time to blow up, for them to blow up. And the body can be like that. So, metaphysically, cells are the body. Structural and functional units of organisms made up of atoms, composed of electrons and protons, which in reality have their origin in the supermind. The supermind, the higher state of consciousness. These cells are adjusted one to the other through associated ideas. When divine love enters into man's thought process, every cell is posed and balanced in right order. That's why we talk about love all the time, the laws of vibrational energy. Law and order rule in the cells of the body with the exactness that characterize their actions in the worlds of a planetary system. We got to know that, we got to understand that, and we have to accept that. So think about it. How do your cells and organs know what to do? Think about it. What caused them to lose function? Think about it. How can you assist them to restore proper function so the body can more easily recover itself? It's our self-healing capacity. Think about those things right there. And don't say you don't have anything to do with it, that I got to go to the doctor and get that pill or have that surgery because it ain't going to change nothing. It's only going to make things different in a different way, but worse in a different way when we do stuff like that. Because I'm going through changes right now as my energy is shifting. But I know it's a positive nature because I'm shaking off. I'm shaking off all the excess that's no longer needed. And family, you can do that. As you take your deep breaths through the week and you focus on yourself and you give your power to no one. And I'm sitting here in my mind, I have to tell the truth and think about it. Brother Kumama Duamala got this t-shirt that he got and it has a Superman emblem on it, but he calls it Black Man. And he got that B in there because the power of blackness, the power of who you are. You got to understand that divine energy in you. And we can connect, family. We can connect with each other around the world through that hashtag, Black People's Kinetic Boycott Ham. Sharing the good news, sharing your business opportunities, sharing everything that we can do to bring about unity and connect us around the world, globally, internationally, locally. We got to start coming together as a unit of one whole. I'm talking about the Black family. We got to stand together no matter where you are, no matter what you're making, no matter what you're thinking, no matter where you're living, no matter whatever. You got to come together. Stop thinking you're above and you're better than someone else. We got to work together. There's so much trying to go against us that we got to come together even more. That's what that hashtag is all about. Black People Kinetic Boycott Ham. bringing us together around the world, sharing our stories, supporting one another. I want to share my health paradigm with you. I want you to share your health paradigm with me. You may know something that I don't know. Put it to that hashtag. I'm out there checking every day, seeing what information, what people are sharing with one another so we can support one another around the world and help people out. And that's what we have to do. We got to stand together as one. We got to become a unit. We got to stop thinking separate, that I don't need my neighbor. We got to come back to being neighbors in the neighborhood. I loved when I was growing up in my neighborhood, even though it seemed like my whole family lived in my neighborhood on my father's side. Like I knew everybody in the neighborhood down the street around the corner because it was family. But there were some people that was there that were neighbors that wasn't family. I was kind of glad that my father's family did all live together and we all lived around one another, and it just made everything so wonderful. But we can look at each other as an extension of family if we truly want to really support one another. That's the mindset that we got to get into. We got to hold on to that mindset so we can support one another around the world. And we can do it with the hashtag Black People's Comedic Boycott Ham. And as Brother Humam Abdul-Malik says, let go of the holidays. Let's get into the real days. Let's apply a little bit of Kwanzaa in our daily lives, those seven principles, and see how we can shift things. Because I sure do love self-determination. Because I am determined. Because of the move beyond the activities of my autonomic system. So in closing, I want to say to you, family, like Reverend Ike says, you deserve the best. Listen to this clip, and you deserve the best. Honor yourself, love yourself, put yourself first. It's not being selfish. Take care of yourself, and you can take better care of everybody else. Ah, send out that love around the world.
If you want to experience the very best of life, you must believe that you deserve the best. Too many religious people are taught to believe that they don't deserve anything. And some religious people even pray that prayer. Oh, Lord, I know I'm not worthy. I'm going to ask for some confessions on national television. How many of you have ever prayed a prayer like that? Lord, I know I'm not worthy. Come on, up with those hands. Chicken. All right, I have too. I know better now. I know the truth and I'm free. But listen, anything that you don't feel you're worthy of, you can't have. Anything that you feel you do not deserve, that you're not worthy of, you automatically cut yourself off from that good. Listen, you cross yourself up when you pray and ask the presence of God in you for something. And then you say, now, Lord, I know I'm not worthy. You might as well forget it, honey. Believe that you deserve the best. Now, let me give you a bombshell. I want everybody to get quiet. Everybody just walk and sit in the nearest empty seat. Quickly, listen. I want you to hear this. If you ever heard anything, I'm going to tell you something that's only going to take 10 seconds to tell you, but I want you to hear this if you forget everything else I've said. Because what I'm about to tell you will bring you anything good that you desire, and it will bring it to you quickly. It will bring it to you in the nowness of consciousness. Listen. Anything that you can actually think and feel that you are worthy of must come to you. Don't clap yet. Hold on. I want to be redundant about this. Please listen. Hang on to every word. Anything that you can honestly think and feel that you deserve must come to you. If any person in this congregation are listening on the radio or looking in on television, if you can honestly think and feel that you are worthy and deserve $1 million, that $1 million must come to you. philosophy, which we call the science of living, we say it this way: whatever you want in your experience, hold it first of all, accept it first of all in your consciousness. If you could get $1 million feeling, $1 million would have to come to you if it looked like it was dropping out of the sky. It wouldn't actually be coming from outside of you. It would be coming from within your own consciousness. And of course, this is one of the great mystic secrets. Nothing really comes to you from outside of you. Everything comes to you from within your own consciousness. Everything comes to you from within your own inner feeling about yourself. Not according to what others think and feel about you, but your experiences come to you. Your cursing or your blessing, your good or your evil, comes to you out of your own inner consciousness. And once again, let me make the startling statement. If any person could honestly feel and think that he is deserving and worthy of $1 million, that $1 million would come to him so fast until it would make his head spin. Now, wait a minute. We've had an example in this service. Mother Packnett, who used to be the blind old lady and who was healed. And she was taught by me in many of our services that we deserve the best. This is what I teach the people, that you deserve the best. You deserve the best because you're God's child. You don't have to beg God for anything. The day of begging, praying is over. This is the day of accepting the goodness of God.
You got to accept the goodness of what's already given to you by your states of consciousness, and that includes health. You can shift yourself right now, family. I want to thank you for tuning in, and I want you to understand something. Listen to those commercials now, because they're talking about psychiatric drugs. They never put the two together before, drugs of the body and psychiatric drugs. The truth about psychiatry, in short, the whole business of creating psychiatric categories of diseases, formalizing them with consensus, and subsequently ascribing, diagnosing codes to them, which in turn leads to the use of insurance billing, is nothing but an extended racket furnishing psychiatry a placebo scientific aura. I'm trying to tell you, family, you got to think about something. Get your kids off of them drugs. Don't put your kids on them drugs talking about you can't control their behavior. Be parents. Be real parents. Be loving parents. And love yourself. Wow, family, that was a great show. I want to thank you so very much for tuning in to the Conscious Self Healthcare Conversation Radio Show right here on Inner Light Radio. It was a pleasure having you tuning in. Now, you must tell a friend to tune in. And if you haven't called in and shared your wellness story, don't you think it's time that you help somebody with your wellness story? Call in, share your story, join the conversation. I'm Karen Khadija Davis, folks, and I invite you to visit my website, ConsciousSelfCare.com. Or you can just go to the number 4, the word CELLLIFE.com. Leave me some information. I would love to talk with you. And once again, I look forward to you joining us next Wednesday right here on the Conscious Self Healthcare Radio Show. It's a conversation where we uplift each other, where we share our wellness story so we can help someone move from disease care to conscious self healthcare. Thank you for tuning in. I look forward to hearing from you next Wednesday.